Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we have two interesting SpaceX updates for you. First, we'll cover SpaceX CEO's recent plans to catch Super Heavy boosters, followed by an interesting interview with Rocket Lab CEO and his viewpoint on Starship's future. So let's start with our first update. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has expressed his first official statement on SpaceX's probable plans to catch Super Heavy boosters and how it may look like in real life. Though the animation shared by Musk answers less and raises more questions. Starting at the end of 2020, Elon Musk has been nurturing the idea of catching starships and Super Heavy boosters from the sky. This idea popped up as an alternate approach to have several dozen-ton steel rockets land on an elementary concrete with legs. It very well may be a significant takeoff from SpaceX's exceptionally efficient Falcon family, which land on a complicated set of deployable legs that can be withdrawn after soft landings. The exceptionally adaptable, lightweight designs, for the most part, have been dependable and effectively reusable, yet Falcon boosters once in a while experience harsh landings which can utilize disposable shock absorbers or even damage the legs and make boosters hard to secure. As a modestly sized rocket, Falcon boosters must be incredibly lightweight to guarantee solid payload margins and logically weigh around 25 to 30 tons while vacant and 450 tons completely fueled, a great mass proportion for a reusable rocket. While it's still great to proceed with that act of thorough mass optimization with Starship, the vehicle is totally a unique story. When the plan to extend the Starship's upper stage tanks and add three additional Raptors are materialized, it's very conceivable that the Starship vehicle will be equipped for launching excess of 200 tons, about 440,000 pounds of payload to low Earth orbit (LEO), along with ship and booster recovery. One may imagine that SpaceX, with the most able rocket at any point possibly on its hands, may exploit that remarkable presentation to make the actual rocket, likely the most complicated launch vehicle perhaps. But for obvious reasons, that would include compromising a portion of its payload capacity and adding systems that are heavier, yet less complex and more strong. When Starship is routinely traveling to orbit and giving bunches of flight insight and information, SpaceX may then be capable to refine the rocket, steadily decreasing its mass and further improving payload to orbit by streamlining or completely replacing imperfect systems and designs. Considering everything, SpaceX seems to be significantly enhancing Starship before it attempts their first single orbital launch. Elon Musk's plan to catch Super Heavies and perhaps Starships as well seems to be the biggest example and the sole motivation behind, in his own words, saving landing leg mass and enabling immediate reflight of a giant rocket. SpaceX CEO and other executives, or both, give off an impression of being attempting to refine the rocket that's never flown. Though looking at the simulation of a Super Heavy catch, Musk shared on January 20th, unfortunately, all that strangely planned exertion might end up delivering a solution that's really more questionable than what it's attempting to replace. If we look at the simulated telemetry shown in the visualization by Musk, Super Heavy's descent to the landing zone looks like significantly gentler than the suicide burn SpaceX regularly uses on Falcon. By decelerating as fast as could be expected and making landing as short as it could be expected, Falcon saves a lot of propellant during recovery. If in any case required, it would effectively increase Falcon's effective dry mass and decrease its payload to orbit. The booster seems to be landing as per the Super Heavy catch SpaceX has displayed just on a minuscule patch of steel on the arms instead of concrete pad on the ground. Besides some horizontal movement, The arms seem motionless during the catch, making it more of a landing. Further, Super Heavy is decelerating slowly all through the simulation and seems to drift for right around 10 seconds close to the end. That sluggish yet careful descent and surprisingly more slower touchdown might be essential considering how extraordinarily precise Super Heavy must be to land on a couple of hard points with very less margin of error, perhaps a couple of square feet of usable surface region. Beside requesting exact rotational control, even the smallest lateral deviation would make the booster overturn off the points of support and, on account of Super Heavy, fall around 100 feet onto concrete, where it would clearly explode. Set forth plainly, while Starbase's launch tower arms will, without a doubt, be helpful for rapidly lifting and stacking Super Heavy and Starship, it's looking increasingly more probable that involving those arms as a landing platform will, best-case scenario, be an alternative option in contrast to usual Falcon-style landings. All the more significant, regardless of whether everything works impeccably, the arms really help out boosters to catch them, and it's feasible for Super Heavy to try not to drift and utilize a more productive self-destruction mechanism. The best-case result is imperceptibly quicker reuse and maybe a 5% increment in payload to orbit. The truth will surface eventually, assuming such an extreme change ends up being worth such minimal advantages. Let's move towards our next segment now. In a recent interview with Inverse, Rocket Lab CEO Peter Beck has cautioned that SpaceX's Starship may not go as it's planned. The organization's being worked on rocket, first laid out in 2017, is intended to send people to Mars and then beyond. Yet at its disclosing, CEO Elon Musk said that he wanted one booster and ship that replaces the existing Falcon 9, Falcon Heavy, and Dragon. That implies a ship that can likewise launch satellite constellations like Starlink. In a recent exclusive interview with Inverse, Rocket Lab CEO Peter Beck proposed that SpaceX CEO Elon Musk's vision may get derailed. Talking after the furthest down the line updates to its Neutron rocket project, Beck clarified that the Starship wouldn't assist with building satellite constellations in coming days. As per Beck, if you want to populate Mars, then the Starship is the vehicle to do that. He says if you want to deploy a bunch of constellations and spacecraft in low Earth orbit, 100 tons of payload is just not going to help you. The remarks smother a regularly promoted statement regarding Starship, where the Falcon 9 can launch around 16 tons to low Earth orbit in reusable setup, the Starship can launch more than 100 tons. As per previous remarks made by Elon Musk, he's referenced that he intends to utilize the Starship for satellite launch. In June 2021, he tweeted that Starlink missions would move to Starship. Current Falcon 9 rockets are capable to launch up to 60 Starlink satellites at once, which could mean a large expansion in the payload capacity. However, Starlink isn't the main constellation available on the market. Amazon's Project Kuiper and competitor Telesat also plan to use many satellites in low Earth orbit for internet access. Rocket Lab planned its Neutron, set for its first trip in 2024, to launch 8 tons. Beck contends that a smaller rocket is better for working out groups of constellations, since one can focus on numerous orbital planes without deliveries to orbit. Beck mentioned, "If you want to put the constellation in one orbital plane, then that's fine, but that's not particularly useful. Having multiple planes is generally more useful." Voicing for smaller rockets, Beck further added, "You don't get a discount for putting 8 tons in a 100-ton rocket," he says. "The rocket price is the same." When combined with the Electron rocket, Beck contends that Rocket Lab can lift around 90% of all that is planned inside the approaching 10 years. However, that actually leaves Starship and others for heavy lift missions. If the discussion is regarding a rocket that can replace Falcon 9, that all relies upon whether SpaceX can offer launches at an appealing cost. Whereas Musk guarantees the ship would cost just $2 million for each launch, seriously undermining the Falcon 9's $62 million sticker price. That's all we had to offer today. We'll soon come back with more updates. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.